Hi, everybody. Welcome to the QB School. I am JT O'Sullivan. Today, X's and O's. Fired up for a little sale action here. So let's dive into it. Welcome to the QB School. So the idea for this video came from Michael Ciabola. Hey, JT. I thought of a couple X's and O's videos that you haven't covered. Mills, Sale, Y-Cross, thanks, and keep up the good work, my man. Excellent question there, suggestions. We'll probably eventually get to all of those, although I am by no means a certified expert on the final one there. But for this one, we are doing the Sale concept. Now, I have intentionally kind of avoided the Sale concept up until this point. I know it is a fan favorite out there for many football X's and O's aficionados. For me, okay, for me here, there's a lot of nuance and blurry, muddy territory when we start talking about Sale. The other part about it is I just don't like it that much at its true, pure form. The other thing here is that many of these concepts can mean many different things to many people. I think Sale is one that really puts that on steroids. So there's a bunch of different ways to do this, what exactly it looks like. I'm going to do my absolute best in a somewhat precise, concise manner to be able to at least define the term that we're talking about and then kind of show its bare bones way to do it and then really show how it's most often done. And so before we even jump into it, let's define exactly what the sale route, sale combination is in its purest form. At its purest form, broken down all the way to the bare bones, I personally think of it as a three-person concept. Many people think of it as a two-person concept. So let's go from the outside in to start. The outside route has a go takeoff nine route, usually must outside release. It is essentially a clear, some teams will alert it versus specific looks. And then the inside route is really the sale route. Now, this is where we start getting into some significant nuance. The sale route, I think, can best be described as a 12-ish yard, whether you do it by steps. I've seen some teams do it by steps. Some teams do it by yardage landmarks. 12-ish kind of rounded out, not necessarily a true corner. Okay, so we're already kind of in that blurry world where it's not like a speed out, a 10-yard square out, but it's not a corner where you kind of set it maybe a little deeper, 20, 25. It's kind of that in-between kind of thing. And then to complicate it, a lot of teams versus man coverage or man technique will run kind of square outs out of it. Okay, so if I haven't lost you already, essentially at the bare bones of it, two-person concept, think of it as a clear on the outside and that sail route where you're kind of just sailing into the open area, whether it's zone or man. And that is essentially the two-person combination. Now, I personally think of it as a three-person combination. It doesn't have to be a two-person side. It can be a route coming from the other side. But I think of it as there needs to be something in the flat to pull that flat defender down so that you can throw the sail route behind it. So I think of it as a three-person route where the outside go clear, the sail route by the number two, and then the number three is running usually like a five-yard square out, kind of a pull flat. The other common way to do it is to have a drive or shallow route coming from the backside show up and try to pull that flat defender. Because if that flat defender gets depth and runs out underneath the sail, then you need somewhere to go with the ball. You can either check it down, something in the flat. And so whether you're trying to get them to gather that flat defender and come down on the flat to throw the sail behind it or vice versa, to me, that's what it is. So it's a clear, that kind of rounded corner, which we will call a sail. And then I'll show you exactly what that looks like. And then something underneath it in the flat. A bunch of different ways to get there, whether it's a check down, a flat, a shallow from the other side. And that's really the concept when it's totally broken down. Now, does any team run it just like that? I'm sure there are probably some teams. Most teams at the highest level of football do not run it like that. Okay, so we're already doing a concept that I think the way that most people understand it isn't necessarily the way that it's run. So how do most teams run it? I will tell just anecdotally, I prefer this play with a big post on the outside versus clear. You get the same, for the most part, the same structure of the play. You get kind of that super high three-level type route on the outside. You get the outside big post. You get the sail route. And then you get that flat underneath, whether it's a flat or shallow from the other side. But with a post, you get a quarters alert. And so versus quarters, you can really throw that post up and over the top if that feel, if that safety sitting on the sail or the vertical of number two kind of startles his feet at all, or kind of, you know, doesn't necessarily get any depth to take away that post. Now, the potential downside to that is if you run a post, the corner, depending on their technique, can see the release of the number two. And so if they can jump the number two and see that sail route come off, they can pass it off. Now, that's why it's important about the depth of these things. Usually somewhere between 8, 10, maybe 12, if you're just ridiculous baller on the perimeter defensively, are you passing things off that deep? Usually once they get that deep, the technique of most match coverages will have them locked on it. But there is still the opportunity for that corner to see it, you know, depending on what type of coverage he's in. Even if he's in like a true country cover three with his kind of rear to the sideline, eyes inside, he can see that kind of corner come off and has the potential, if he wants to get nuts, to go drive that kind of sail route, depending on how and when you throw it. So I prefer it with a post because it's a great quarters alert. It's also a good cover zero alert. And I think that's how most people do it. The other thing that I like that will show a bunch of images, I prefer to run this sail concept from a stacked or bunch formation because you can really manipulate the leverage. And we'll talk about exactly how that looks like. And then finally, at the end of this one, I'm experimenting with a few new playbooks. So there'll be significantly more images in this. But then at the very end, I will show exactly how maybe the defense would look at try to pass some of these off, depending on what type of coverage you're in. So little wrinkles within this one. I think you're really going to like it. But again, one more time, let's just, for the people who have never heard of sail before, sail is a clear on the outside. And because we're clearing that thing out, we're going to run kind of a rounded corner deeper out into that area. And there's going to be a flat route. So it's a three level kind of flood type concept to the sideline. So let's get into it. Sail. All right. So the first one we're looking at here sail wise is from the old Cincinnati playbook. Don't worry necessarily about the formation, the personnel, got a little motion, pass pro, sets the deep of the pocket, and then the 860 sail. So we can see the sail right here. So let's first look at the sail. We've got the F motion. So he's coming in motion. He's running the sail. We're coming up. You can see the depths here. 12 yard versus man, we're coming out flat. Versus zone, we're kind of rolling it into that 15 yard window. Now I think it's important to differentiate between this and a true corner. So true corner here comes up, and usually to me at like 10-ish yards, you're going to knot it, and then you're going to run out to a landmark. I prefer 25 yards on the sideline. Different teams, different landmarks. That's the difference. So we're talking about nuance here as far as what this route looks like. Now, I will tell you, you know, I have a whole course on a whole offense. I didn't run a sail route at the high school level. Doesn't mean you can't do it. We had outs and we had corners and we basically blended them together. But this is really detailed stuff as far as you're going to carry the sail, you're going to carry an out, you're going to carry a speed out, a stick, a corner, etc. So that is the sail route that we will talk about in this video. 12-ish, versus man, we're breaking away. Versus zone, we're rolling into that window, throwing that thing outside the numbers on the sideline. Now this one, it's paired. Again, you talk about the bones of it. There's not a clear or a go or a takeoff or a nine here. That's a post, eight. Okay, you're welcome for that, digit peeps. Okay, six, backside in this offense. I always prefer an in to be four, but going a different, that will be a different video. And then the zero is the shallow, so coming across. So this looks pretty similar to a lot of what West Coast people would think, like flanker drive, zebra corner, or zebra out. Okay, again, you play to me, this gets closer to scissors. You know, a lot of people, scissors will be post, big post with a corner. You know, this is what we ran at the high school level. I didn't necessarily think we needed to get into this. We also didn't see a whole lot of zone type coverages where this would be great. But you can see here the three level, right? So three level flood, that deep shot, that intermediate, and then the shallow or the flat. So if someone, the flat defender on defense, were to get any sort of depth and get underneath that sail, then you've got this drive coming right underneath it. So that's the sail route. Get a good, because we'll see this a bunch of different ways, but it's important to understand that's that sail concept route. Same playbook, similar play, different way to get there, still with the motion. We really liked running the F motion for some reason on this team. Again, I like this play versus two man. I know it says that right here, if you can read my scribble, just because you're running away from usually two man technique Also a pretty common third down type play here with a bunch of runaways versus man type options. You know, third and medium, you get a chance for a big quarters beater. You got a zero beater over here for the post. But again, this is the same play, right? I mean, it's the big eight. Here comes the sail. We've got the shallow coming across with the drive, and we've got the backside in. Now, how we get there, the personnel is different, whatever, it doesn't really matter. Once you understand sail here, and it's really the sail route versus the true form of it, to me, and again, it's just to me, of that go, takeoff, clear with that flat. So three levels, and that sail is that intermediate kind of on the sideline rolled out. Now, again, the yardage here are a little bit different. And this is what playing in the league is like, where these things will change based on, you know, down and distance, week, game, whatever, training camp, mini camp, you know, different coordinator, different coaches. But you can see here, I've already shown two images from the same team, from the same playbook with different depths. So it, again, it's not in cement, not in pen here, exactly what this sail is. But at the end of the day, if you thought, hey, I'm going to watch this long-ass video, I need to get come away with one takeaway. This sail is a three-level sideline concept. We got the go or takeoff. We got the sail. We got something in the flat. Next one here, again, from the same playbook. Now, it's going to be called something different, but the bones of it are the same. And I like this one a little bit better just because it shows all that number three coming from the same side. But you can see here, we get a little bit of a stack formation, first of all. And again, doesn't matter what they called it. They called it sting to condense the formation. Then we get this. You see the takeoff or the post. We see the sail route. And again, the other thing I like about sail routes in most offenses, and again, this is dependent on this specific type of stack formation, but this idea being burst release this thing or inside release versus outside release. Now, why would you want to not do that? There are a few different reasons. I prefer a burst release because one, it, depending on what type of coverage this is, it's usually pretty unsettling for these guys. They see you burst release. Most defenders are thinking he's going shallow. So you unsettle them, you get them out of their technique. In addition, the other thing that I really like about it, especially on outbreaking routes, is you just open the window. So this sail route now has this window, as opposed to if you just ran up from where you are and ran the sail, you have this window. Okay? What size window you want to throw into? I prefer the bigger window. Thanks a lot. Hot take there. Okay, so again, you how you teach that, is it a burst release? Does it depend on the formation? All those things can be nuanced part of it. I think this bow concept was more of a two-minute call, give us specific open-close man zone reads. But you can see here, this side of it, this is sail. And we've got the three levels, the big post, or the clear takeoff, the sail route, and then we've got something in the flat to pull that flat defender down or to take advantage of the flat defender getting depth. This next image is true old school West Coast. So from Saints, Mike McCarthy days, this is a little bit more of how I think of old school sail, where we've got the clear locked route. So this is a must outside release, clear. We're not, we cannot throw it. We've got the alert corner. So this isn't really true sail to me, where it'd be burst up, rolled out type thing. This is a true corner, but you can see the spacing of it. So clear, corner, and then we've got that drive coming across. Now the reads here are a little bit different. This is alert versus a specific type of coverage. And to me, I don't love this play for a bunch of different reasons. But you can see here, we used to read this as a progression with an option. So that option, that corner, that sail, just because it's attacking the same, just because I'm calling it a corner, it's attacking the same structure of the defense. Blowing the top off the coverage, got that intermediate sideline throw, and then we got something in the flat showing up. So we got the bones of sail just by being able to get there in West Coasty verbiage. Sail to me is not a true West Coast concept that gets run a lot, but you can get there in damn near any verbiage of offense. All right, this next one is from the Martz world, Digit world. This was our two-minute call. We just called it sail, a one-word call, kind of one-word calls before they were one-word calls. Again, you can see here, again, this is a little bit more scissorsy because we've got the post, the big eight, action eight. We've got that burst release sail. Again, check the depths, y'all. Different team, different depths. Okay, no shocker, Mike March is going to push the depth there. Okay, and then we've got something showing up in the flat. Got that drive or shallow coming all the way across. And again, just to see here what these are hot options. You know, 2 minute, six person slide protection. Got a bunch of different ways to redirect the hots or the pass pro. The other thing here to pay attention to is he put this thing into the boundary. A little bit easier of a throw. And it's a little bit different in the league with the tighter hashes. But just understand that this can be a field or boundary concept, especially in the league. Other thing with here, with this shallow here, is that this little in and out line, that just means this technique is called stair stepping. So you get a defender who's right on you. He's running with you man to man. He's tailpiping you, trying not to get picked, especially nowadays with all the meshes. So you run in there. You give him the old Julian Edelman, right? You run in there, shuttle your feet a little bit, make him look like a jerk, and keep running, okay? Or you can just come in there, if I can clear it, come in there, step up, and then keep running, just to make that guy jump his technique so he can't get comfortable running in your hip. So there's that sail. Again, different depths. You know, what is it paired with? It doesn't matter. It's a three-level sideline rolled corner-ish concept. This is that same Martz 2 minute package here. We call this stack. Again, this is the same concept for me, but you'll notice these things are condensed, right? This formation is condensed, built-in condensed. 4 yards outside the hash, normal sail split or seven split in this offense. So they're going to switch release this thing. Okay, again, disorienting to the DBs as long as you can get off the line of scrimmage. Push this thing up. You got the big eight. Then you've got the sail coming out underneath it. So he goes second up and rolls it out. And again, you can see here they've got different things for different coverages. So you can run away from the coverage here. Man coverage, keep it high or flat. Zone coverage, read that corner. If it's a cloud corner, okay, read that flat defender, and then you've got something in the flat. So again, how we're getting there, what we're calling it, it's a bunch of different things. It doesn't matter. We know how to play sail now. Now on the backside, they just threw a little hot just in case you didn't want to work this thing or you got all out pressure, you didn't think you had enough time, because this burst eight, not quite as good versus zero, because this thing will take forever, right? You're gonna get that switch release. Now, I love me some switch stack releases like this where you do that. I mean, it's really disorienting to DBs. They got to be really locked in to be able to keep their leverage, and you got great opportunities for one of these guys to pop if you have enough time to drop this thing in. Next one here, this is really true sail, in my opinion. So this is true digit 479. So got the backside four. In case you're wondering how you do this digit system, the single receiver gets the first letter. The two receivers or two eligibles together get the second and third number. So again, if this was flipped, it would be 974. Okay, if that makes sense. So don't get it twisted about who gets who with the numbers. It's just single receiver first, combo receivers or two eligibles next, and then the F gets his own tag, okay, in most digit systems. So this is the true, to me, this is what sail looks like. A nine, go takeoff with that burst release rolled kind of deep out. And again, you'll notice there's a shallow or drive coming from the backside to be there if it's not there. So if the star, if the flat defender, if whoever's out here with this area of the field covered wise, and it could be the corner too, if it get a cloud or whatever, if someone decides to get depth and get out underneath that sail route, that seven here, then you need to be able to throw it to whatever the flat replacement is. So here it's just a drag route, shallow, drive, whatever you want to call it. Again, you can see the reads here back in the day. I'm not sure what exactly we were doing. This might be like a mini camp thing. Cover three, close, we're going to work the sail first. Open, we're going to work a little triangle, old school read. And I don't love sail versus a cloud look. I don't love it versus true quarters either. I prefer to have the scissors. I know I've already mentioned it. But versus true country cover three, great, let's do it. Sail it away. Another Martz play here, okay, 478. So again, here's the four, here's the seven, here's the eight. Love how we get here this time with a little shorty motion. Again, disorienting. Hopefully get the leverage that you want. What leverage do you want on this sail route? You want the DB inside you. So you want him thinking, oh man, he's going to come in here short motion and run this shallow and drive like every team in all levels of football do. All right, well, that's not gonna happen now. So now we're gonna shorty it, get squared up with your hips, hit this thing with some speed, create the bigger window, and then you got all this space to be able to go run this thing into. Again, a quarters play. Why? Because we got the action eight alert or big eight, big post, whatever. And again, you should already see it. You've got this flat, you've got double flat replacements here with the lucky call. That was just a check down variation out of a seven person protection, which was Bronco in the system. So again, almost always going to have, for all my people in the back, some variation of a clear or a post. That seven route or sail, not a true corner, kind of up and rolled out, and then we're going to have something in the flat. That is the sail concept. Closed, open. If it's open, you can see here, stare down that sail, come back, rip that thing right there. Everybody loves a good deep in the March system. Another one here from the digit system. It's a little bit different, just as far as there aren't digits in here, but you can see here, again, this is how I really like it with the stacked formation. This is really eight person protection here with the auto. Again, built in checkdowns. Something's gonna be in the flat. So we've got the switch release. I'm not gonna go through it again because I've already done it. Switch release, disorienting, big post. You gotta get on your horse and get that rolled seven coming out. Something in the flat. Love it. Now we're still in the digit system, March world, but now this is a little bit more what I consider like goal liney. This is also, you know, borderline similar to everyone's favorite. what does he call it? Hound 2, Spider Y Banana or something like that, where it's just this kind of like rolled goal line. I think of this more as like true goal line. This might have been out in the field, short yardage. Yeah, but again, the 79, that's digit world for sale. Got the 9 takeoff. Disorienting. Okay, again, burst release this thing. Up, roll it, run away versus man. And we got something in the flat off the little power pass. Again, reading that corner. Hopefully the corner does what? Corner equals flat, want seven though. This is the intent of the play. We're trying to throw the corner. I want the seven route. Still staying in the digit world. This is a really cool variation that I really liked. And really it's just this seven stop. Okay, so seven stop here. Is it basically a corner that turns into like you turn over your outside shoulder and it's like a little curl. It's like a reverse post curl. So to me, it's always great versus zone coverage, especially if you're a sail team, if you're a corner team. So again, coming out 10 yards. The really important part with this seven stop or any corner stop to me, to be able to throw this thing with any sort of anticipation. So you want to learn how to get anticipation. You're out there playing quarterback, teaching maybe anticipation to your quarterbacks. You need specific landmarks. 15 yards inside edge of the numbers. So I could take seven here or big five, whatever, and let that thing rip because I knew he's going to be 15 yards at the edge of the numbers in zone coverage. So keep my eyes over here, come back here and throw that thing as hard as I can right on his face, 15 yards down the field. Really specific landmarks. 2 yards outside the hash is the starting point. Inside edge of the numbers is the landmark. Seven stop. Again, this is a really fun play. This is not an easy throw here for all my tight eight fans on the backside. This is a serious cluster. But you can see here, not great versus man. There's not a lot of whole great man options here. Really, tight eights used to turn into nine. So you got 2 nines on the outside. But this is the bones and why it's in this video of sail, right? We've got a takeoff, go, nine. We've got a seven, sail. We've got something in the flat. So it looks like sail. Then all of a sudden you run sail a few times, boop, put your feet on the ground, rip it right there. Love this concept, especially like high red zone where you can still kind of anticipate some zone coverages, especially in the league. Really nice call with the seven stop. Next one here, I put in here because I just want to show how blurry some of this stuff can be or messy. So this is technically to me not sail. Okay, so we've got the go takeoff, we've got something in the flat, and we've got an intermediate out throw. What are you talking about, bro? It's just what you described. Yeah, not so much. So this is an eight, so here's the angle eight on the backside, 839 as opposed to 79. So first thing you should notice is the depth, a little bit shorter. It's also not that like rolled to 15 to 18-ish. This is a true three almost speed out. So we're coming out running away. Now, for all you significant offensive gurus out there, you should know that this kind of looks like stick. This is like a deep stick. Coming in here, up, stick would be right there. It'd be out into the flat, happen a little quicker. This is like that deeper stick. Deeper stick, shallower sail. Makes sense? Great. On to the next. All right, now we're going to bounce around a number of different playbooks here. This is from old school Harbaugh 49ers playbook. And this is kind of a nice thing to just kind of, okay, let's take a step back here. What is sail? This is sail, or it was to Harbaugh in the mid-teens. Okay, a go route and that sail corner. 12 to 15, go route. Now, I would even add to this, must outside release go, but maybe that's not how they read it. And that's really it, right? Two person, bare bones, is as bare as you can get. Two person concept, sail. This is from some old school Dallas playbooks and really, you know, digit system, 078. We're going to get that again. You know, to me, this is borderline scissors. The reason it's not true scissors is because this is not a true corner. This is that sail route. Comes out and like rounds it, deep, rounded, almost banana-ish in. But you can see that 78 versus 79 with the go. You know, it's still attacking the same thing. You still see the same bones, right? We've got a deep threat. We've got that intermediate sail route. We've got something in the flat. Bunch of different ways to do it. Almost every offense has some variation of it. And as long as you understand it's that three level, you know, whether you think of it as high to low, low to high, I don't love to think of it in those terms. I think of it as, you know, what is the concept on the outside? Is it a go or a post? If it's a post, it's a quarters, zero alert. Everything else, I'm trying to throw the sail. If I can't throw the sail because if somebody gets so much depth, then I've got something underneath it. I'm not going to come out here and just rip a 5 yard out that's wide open, you know, off, you know, 1.5 seconds when I'm trying to throw the sail. What is the intent of the play? The intent of the play is to throw the sail or the seven. Another playbook here from our friends at Clemson. Got that sail route. And again, this is kind of old school sail to me. Besides for this drawing being old school with not very much detail, you can see here, take off, go, that's sail. Again, it's got specific landmarks on the hash. This is to the field or to the wide side, especially in college or wide hash high school. They paired it with an over. Doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter what's on the backside. This is the sail. Clear number one. Whatever that route is, we'll call it a sail versus a corner or a deep out, and then something in the flat. And there it is. Beautiful. Bunch of different ways to do it. They had different ways to do it, different people to do it. But at the end of the day, the concept is the same, y'all. It's a go, a takeoff, a post. It's a sail, a corner, a deep out, and it's something in the flat. High, low, or three level sideline play. This one, I believe, is from old school BC. They called it Florida. Call it whatever the hell you want, strawberry milkshake. We've got a deep post or converted versus cloud to a clear. That's convenient. We've got that sail route. Boom, right there. Then we've got something in the flat. Comes the check down or the check down from the back swing. So again, the concept is the same. We at Clemson, they did 12 to 16 to 18. Again, you can see that the ability to round that thing in there. It's got a great quarters beater. And again, we can even see what their progression is here. And they went Z to Y to A to T. All right. So just 1, 2, 3, 4. They went crazy with the colored fonts here too. It feels like, remember those old school pens with like the four different colors? Probably dating myself, but this looks like someone learned how to take notes with that pen. This one is from Bowling Green, I think. They called it Flossy, whatever. They run it with a little switch here with the little short motion. And again, I'm always gonna love that. First of all, the short motion, love the switch release-ish. Okay, but again, the play is the play is the play. Sail is sail is sail. Three level, sideline type play, trying to rip that sail. Call a switch sail, whatever, flat control. Again, there's a bunch of different ways to describe this to me, whether it's, you know, immediately into the flat, You're running this from the check down, you're running this from the other side of the field, doesn't matter. It's three layers on the sideline. This next one is from some old school TCU. Again, sail, easy to see, right? Three levels, you have to go takeoff, must outside release. Here we go, I appreciate that detail. And we've got that, what is the yardage? 12, just to wherever. I can also tell you that I'm just not a huge fan of, and this is maybe too much of my own issues, but what's the point of having a defense on these cards? Like, this just muddies the picture. Just, I don't know, whatever. It muddies it to me. But we've got that sail 7. We've got something in the flat. You're welcome. Three levels, sideline, takeoff, sail, flat. I don't even know or remember what playbook this is from. Some digit system. You can see the color here. We see the 478. Again, the reason I put this one on here is just because the sail route to me is a little bit different. Now, I personally would call this a different concept. So they call it sail. To me, this is a little bit more like we're faking the cross and coming back out. But at the end of the day, the spacing is the same, right? There's a deep threat with the post. There's that sail route. And there's that flat. You've seen it before. Now, at the high school level that I was coaching at, we called this a different play. We were really trying to sell that over. You'd almost get your eyes back in here like this and then run out back the other way. I think most teams would call this something else. This team called it sail. So again, you can see here, you know, the blurriness of what the hell this route is. We've seen it a bunch of different ways already, all within really what I would consider somewhat high level playbooks. So, but at the end of the day, it's still a three level sideline play with a takeoff, a go, a post, that sail 7. And something in the flat. Another college playbook here. Again, I don't speak this language, but I can tell you what a sail is. Again, we should be able to see it, recognize it pretty easy now. Again, I think it's important to realize the fluidity here of some of these depths. So this is an 8 to 10 yard corner. Now, maybe that's because he's coming from the backfield. I would say it probably is because we can see here the exact same team. Now he's at 15 when he's coming from motion at the line of scrimmage. So again, this is the first time we've seen this type of route. They call it an escape, call it a whip, a pivot, an arrow, whatever you want. It doesn't matter, right? Why does it not matter? Because it's getting someone in the flat. So whatever the timing is, here's another college example of sail. Again, you can see alert versus quarters or four. Same thing, paying attention to most consensus here with the depths, 12-ish to 15-ish. We're rolling out there. There's something in the flat. I mean, at this point, I feel like we could all go into any system and rip some sort of sail concept. From that same book here, this is actually one of my more favorite ways to do it. I don't speak this system, but you could figure it out. Two jet, F sail, whatever. This is looks like bunch, right? They start in bunch. They do a little in and out motion, whatever. They call it Y counter. And then they're going to run a switch release. Love a good switch release. If you don't switch release, you're missing out. So there's that sail route up. In, I would imagine the point guy goes first, so he's running that kind of spray red line go whatever post. We're going to sprint, come in, widen that hole, and got all sorts of room to be able to run away versus man, run into that soft spot versus zone. But at the end of the day, it's the same concept: deep, intermediate sail, something in the flat, three level sideline. Couldn't leave this one out for all my mature people out there. Not sure why it's called that. Get a little, looks like short motion here. They run it with a back pylon. To me, this is a flag. This is taking three level sideline to the extreme here. Back pylon to me means this is like a deep, deep corner. They do call it a flag, there you go. Up, and then you're looking over your outside shoulder running to the back pylon. Okay, here's that kind of rolled. They're doing it off steps here. Again, there's not a lot of guys I know that can run as fast as they can and think 10 steps. But that's just me. Maybe these guys were great at math. Hey, but at the end of the day, high low. Now with a new route, right? A flag, a sail, and there's that flat. So it's, again, three level sideline sail concept. For all my certified cats out there, you know I wasn't going to leave you out. We got a little 94 here. Okay, old school 94. Love it. What is it? Go. Whatever that sail route is. And you can read it if you want. Attack to space, run towards the sideline, settle in the first hole, whatever. It's a go, It's that sale, and it's something in the flat. Beautiful. Blue right 94. Let's go. Same cert world here. Little 94. This is old school Valdosta State, y'all. You're welcome for this. Go takeoff. Whatever that is. Sail route, they called it. To me, that looks like a square out, but to each its own. Something in the flat. You know, is that 39? Is that more like a 3 versus 7 in some systems? Yes. Whatever. Doesn't matter. Deep, intermediate, flat. 94. Sail. Here's a little sail concept for all you run and shoot gurus out there, if there's such a thing. Yeah, pretty sure this is old school SMU. Again, you can see the deep route. There's a sail route, and there's something in the flat. Got two things in the flat. They don't care. They're coming all the way over. Yeah, again, sail. Ooh, here it is. Nice little teaching point here. Adjustments. Burst, bump, man. Break, flat. Boom. Flat. Flat. Runaway. That's what all those dotted lines are in all the other images. Some interesting depths here. This is throwback time. How about that drop? Three-step angle drop. Oh, baby. And again, for all you half-cert cats out there, we got a little Middle Tennessee. Yeah, they called their sail right here. This, to me, is an old-school digit 39. North clear. All right. Whatever you want. Got you. You got the takeoff or go. And we've got that sail route. They called it a sail. To me, that's square out, but whatever. To each its own. 6-1, half dozen to the other. Deep, intermediate, flat. Sort of sail. All right, let's try a little new experimental way to finish this thing off. We're going to do a little Sabanese here to finish this thing off. Now, I'm not fluent in Saban, but we've got a little 3-buzz Mabel. Everybody's favorite. Verse trips empty. We're going to look at this one right here. Let's look a little closer. So how are they going to try to match this thing up? Because there's a bunch of different ways to do it. A little star right here, nickel defender, the money in the Mac, whatever. It doesn't matter what you call them. Don't care. They're going to run this thing, have the corner go with the takeoff. So he's out of there. We've got the star with outside leverage on the flat. Not good for us offensively. I do feel like I'm like doing this from the southern hemisphere here backwards. But then guess what we've got? We've got the 7, that sail route with leverage versus safety who's coming down trying to match the vertical on number 2. Okay, so he look where his leverage is. Look where our route's running. Now, that's a great opportunity for a big throw over there, depending on what your matchups are, whatever, whatever. But that's exactly where you would hope the ball would go. If it wasn't there for whatever reason, you got to get back to the backside in, who's potentially running away from some sort of match corner. So you'd probably go 1-2 in this type of coverage. Now, it's passing over that flat that we talked about, but that's because he's outside leveraged with that star defender. Not going to be where you want to go with the ball. So again, then you make every defense try to react like this. And it's just tough when you get these 3-level flood concepts. So deep, intermediate, shallow. Now, it doesn't mean that they can't match it up, and they certainly can, but it's a nice way to at least put some stress on a sideline defense. So that is a wrap, the sail concept. Lots to like. Again, I prefer it out of condensed sets. I prefer it with a post. I actually really like it with play action as well. Thrown a number of touchdowns, called a number of touchdowns to the big post, to the corner, a bunch of different ways to be able to do it from stack alignments. You can also pair it with different types of things on the backside, depending on what your read is, why you're trying to throw the sail. But again, just that pure old school sail with the clear, the sail or the 7 and that flat route, you don't see a whole lot anymore. I think there are just better ways to do it. So thank you so much for hanging to the end. I will see you next time. Have a good one.